serious, those in interracial marriages. What obstacles do you face, have you faced that you weren't expecting? My husband and I went to Disney World with my side of the family. So there's 11 black people and only one white man. We're in line and when it's our turn for the ride, they always cut the line off when it got to him. Even after telling the ticket person there were 12 in our group. If he was 5th in line, our group just had to magically stop there. Everyone had to explain that he was in fact part of our group and no, he wasn't trying to cut us. Never been an issue for us. I think the only person who may have said anything about it is her mom grandma. Raised by her grandmother, calls her mom. Haha, I remember the first time I met her grandma. She didn't like me because she liked her previous boyfriend. One of the first things she said to me was, you know she's black, right? Something inside me wanted to joke and go nuuuuuuu and get up and storm out. But then something told me she well didn't get the joke. People of your so's race hitting on them right in front of you because they don't think you're together. White man, Native American wife. I have never met a more chill, based, honest, or strong group of people than my in-laws. It on reservations, in US at least, is completely insane, is full of daily struggle, loss, and silent pain. But my wife's family deals with it without batting an eye. My mom is, stereotypically, high-strung and sometimes says stuff ignorantly that would probably get her kicked out of a black or Latino household. My in-laws think it's all completely hilarious. Every mistake is entertainment. Nothing is sacred. They seriously helped me improve my outlook on life. Edit, this is getting huge. Guys, my wife just showed me this very post and said, hey, honey, this is kind of your experience. Ha, edit 2. Yes. When she said that, I told her that it was me. We had a good laugh. Edit 3. I agree with some of the concerned responses here. Insanity wasn't the right word. I didn't expect 6k updates and I'm getting a lot of confused responses. So I'll clarify myself using better wording. Keep in mind, I see and live this alongside my in-laws every day and have for years. I was only glossing over it with a dramatic generalization because of my familiarity with it. That's all. Sorry to have offended anyone. Edit 4. All that was required to receive Reddit Gold is post long responses to over 100 comments, all while revealing intimate details about my family and community. Neat. Edit 5. So what does Reddit Gold do again? My wife is white. I am Asian. Children go through stages of self-identifying white or Asian. When he was young, my son was annoyed when my wife visited him during school lunch because his friends found out he had a white mother. Now, older, he is not much into Asian culture. I'm Chinese. My so is white. A funny and minor observation we had was that me overfeeding her was a cultural thing. Like, whenever I was snacking on something, I would break her off a piece without question. And it used to hurt my feelings a little bit when she said she didn't want it. Or when I cook. I always cook more than a meal's worth, so whenever she finished her serving, I would refill her plate without even asking her. To her, I'm full means. I don't want to eat a single bite more. Whereas to me, I'm full means. Don't serve me another full-sized portion. It sounds stupid, but it actually took me a while getting used to the fact that someone is unwilling to eat more food and that there's always room for a little more isn't a universal mindset. Trying to explain to my kids what they actually are. I'm half black and half Indian, India. My wife is half black and half white. White guy here, married to Latina woman. Problem, the in-laws. Don't see them too often, but wow is it unpleasant. I took my half Jamaican wife to see my parents in Wales. Deepest, darkest Wales. We then used the opportunity to have a long weekend holiday down there. Turns out a lot of the locals down there are still racist as duck. One pub we had to leave as it was clear the locals were joking with the staff about my missus. The cowards switched to Welsh when we walked in and they noticed her. So we couldn't understand. But the intonation and the sneers were clear. We had food on the way, so duck that place. Hope they did spit in it so they then couldn't eat it themselves. Edit. Okay, this got more attention than I thought it would. To clarify, my entire family is Welsh, going back as many generations as we can trace. My brother and I are the first filthy mudbloods born outside of Wales. Obviously being a white boy in white Welsh family, I had never experienced this side of the culture until I got married. It was not just the one pub. Once I had cottoned onto what was happening, I was watching more closely. Several places we went to visit is notice a distinct change of expression on the faces of those who noticed wife. It made me angry and ashamed. Despite only being Welsh by blood, not nationality, my wife, with much more experience of this kind of thing, thought it was funny. Didn't bother her. We ended up leaving the area because of me, not her, getting upset. This was on the south coast of Wales, in places called Roos and Porthcurry, just west of Barry. We were borrowing my parents' static caravan holiday home in Fontagiri Leisure Park. That place was lovely. The Fontagiri Inn, just outside of the park, however, was the place we had to walk out of. I am a black woman married to a Korean man. Here's just a few of the dumb things we endure. 1. When we go out to eat, we get our leftover food in separate bags and they try to give us separate checks. 2. We run a business and are 50/50 partners together and are successful. It is always my husband's business and his money. Because you know, Asians are always rich. Not sure if prejudiced or sexist. 3. People assume we are never together in lines, at bars, or social events. Can't tell you the amount of times men openly hit on me right next to my husband. Usually only happens if we are just standing next to each other and not really talking. If we are talking, they assume we work together. 4. The stares. OMG, the stares we get. We might as well be Martians. We don't even need to be doing anything special. Just walking in the mall or down the street, people openly gawk. 5. Once time when I went to go test drive a Cadillac, I told the salesperson what I was looking for and he went off to find the car. It took him a really long time for him to locate the model of vehicle I wanted, over half an hour. So I popped my head in the office to tell him, never mind. He then asked me for my social security number. What? I've been buying cars for over 20 years. Never had I had someone ask me for my SSN when trying to test drive a car. Also, I was currently driving a Lexus, so I have been used to dealing with premium dealerships. Now, my husband was sitting next to me in the waiting area and was flabbergasted. I was doing all the talking since it was my car that I was looking to test drive and possibly buy. At that point, my husband stands up and tells the salesman that we were leaving, since he was obviously trying to pre-qualify before even showing me the car. Ah, the looks and stares we got. Plus an apology. I think that whole situation really hit home for my husband. That even between minorities there are the good ones and the bad ones. It hurt his feelings for a long time. Because, to each other, I'm just his wife. And he is just my husband. Nothing more. Nothing less. On a side note, no one in his family has ever been rude or nasty to me. They have always treated me with respect. And also with the deference my position within our family holds. My husband is the eldest son of the eldest son. My family has been nice and respectful to my husband as well. That's one fight we didn't have to have. Although I will say we have had our own issues in building our marriage because of our different cultures. We have since learned what is important to each other and to respect and support that. At the end of the day, you are married to each other and not each other's cultures or families. You have to respect and love the person you lay down with at night. White woman. Black husband. Wasn't expecting him to use more hair products than me. Semicolon. Edit 1. And not only the number of products, but the amount of money and time spent on maintenance. I am not complaining. Though, I use his shampoo sometimes and, good god, I feel like I just stepped out of a Pantene commercial. Edit 2. Some of you are asking what products he uses. It's called Shea Moisture. White man. Hindu. Tamil. Wife. Specifically with respect to obstacles that I wasn't expecting. Obviously I expected a little bit. It's the language barrier, specifically with respect to words that have little translations that don't quite work in English. For example, there's a word in Tamil that literally translates to useless. But the Tamil word is often used colloquially to mean something closer to not currently needed or useless for my current purposes. But that doesn't stop my wife from describing all kinds of people, including me, frequently, as straight up useless. including to their faces, and then wondering why these people either get angry or just avoid her. Also, multiple different Tamil words all tend to be shorthanded into the word thing, which means she often talks like some kind of comedic parody of I don't honestly know, largely unaware of the fact, I need a thing for this thing. It's over by the thing. Can you get it? Looks at me not moving. You just going to stand there and be useless? TL. Doctor, a lot of normal Tamil phrases literally translate into bearishy English ones. Food, it can be trying to agree on this sometimes. Our fridge is east meets west. Wife gets confused as the babysitter on occasion. Having in-laws that live across the planet has been difficult. Would be nice to get a bit of help from them. I am white. She is black. Taking selfies in the sun is a rich. The picture either turns out way too dark or way too bright. Asian. Grew up in the US South. Got picked on all the time. It was just a way of life. Things got a lot better as kids got more mature over time and as society has gotten less and less racist over the past few decades. Grew up and married a white woman, and even though we remained in the South, I feel like we are rarely ever even viewed as an interracial couple, let alone discriminated against. But if you ask my wife, she feels like people treat us and her differently all the time. She says we get looks wherever we go. People have a problem with her last name, the separate checks thing, and other stuff. Me. I'm just glad that they don't appear to be spitting in our food or running up to us and telling us how ungodly we are. White woman. Latin. Immigrant. Husband. I didn't expect to have to clarify we're together so much. Like. Go to a checkout counter. Both put our things on it. Person rings up mine and gives me a total. Like the guy standing 6 inches to my left has nothing to do with me. Just really strange. Seems to happen rarely where we live. Major East Coast city. Happened a lot on our honeymoon. Western National Parks. It was already expected, but unpleasant still. Me. Asian female. Adopted and raised by white family. Husband. White male of German descent. Grandma is Oma and Grandpa Opa still. Raised in rural South USA. Mostly by father and stepmother who could be a Paula Deen clone. My husband's big reveal that he was dating a non-white girl. His dad says, well son, we're just glad she isn't black. Meeting said that. You don't have to squint. It's not that dark in here. This was meant as a joke and I took it as such since there was not malicious intent. Just ignorant joking. I replied with, duck you. Where's the beer? Asked to come for Christmas 2 years later and walk in on husband's stepmother's family giving orations on the sin and prohibitions in the Bible of the Germanic and Asiatic tribes intermixing. We were the family shame until his stepsister was impregnated by a black man out of wedlock. She went on to steal a lot of money for drugs and declare herself a lesbian. Really took the heat off us. Pleasant surprise was from his very German and traditional grandparents. His Oma and mostly blind Opa were immediately accepting. His Opa said, white, black, purple, it all looks the same to me. They were very pleased I was making him finish college and make something of himself as well as procreating to carry on the vet shrinking family name. White male, black female husband wife team here. We've experienced our fair share of obstacles. 1. We were around a liberal town right outside NJ, New Hope, and we were spit on by a motorcyclist on his way out of Main Street. 2. We were in Alexandra VA at one of the old museums, and I went to go pay for my wife and I was stopped at the cash register as I was overpaying. 3. I was stopped by the police before and the cop actually pulled me out of the car and asked me if she was a prostitute and would not believe me until I showed our wedding photo that's in my wallet. 4. Recently I was told I support Donald Trump because I was a white male by some of her not so close family members. I would say most folks in an interracial marriage probably have enough stories to create a book on subtle and not so subtle racism. Interracial. Black plus Native American mix. Woman. White husband. I didn't expect to have to confirm that we were a couple dat a lot. Example. We are in a store. My husband asks a question to the cashier then steps away to look at something. Cashier. To me. Here is the item your friend was asking about. Me. My husband. Thanks. I'm never rich about it. It's not really a big deal. Just unexpected. We really are blessed. We live in the US. And yes, racism is still a big problem. But if anyone is going to receive it, it'll be me. Not him. Not us. Things are changing. And for the better. I was adopted as an infant by a Caucasian couple in New England. The things they had to deal with, and only 27 years ago, blow my mind. Think positive. I love my marriage and my family. I'm Hispanic and he's white. I was born and raised in the US. And so were my parents. I'm super light-skinned and never really identified as culturally Latina until I tried to fit in with his family. They're quiet, well-mannered, and don't really talk about feelings. My family is, and I am, louder, more honest, and I guess a little rough around the edges. In comparison, I had never really noticed before. But I guess we do exhibit some cultural differences. White woman here married to a racy Asian man. We live in a rural area. Lots of staring at us in public. Oh, the staring. Including people who will crane their head all the way around to stare at us going by in, say, the mall or Walmart. The worst part for me is the number of people. Okay, women. Oh, after learning I'm married to an Asian guy, say something along the lines of, oh, I couldn't. I've just never been attracted to Asian men. Or words to that effect. You would not believe the number of people who say this straight to my face. Who knows why? What are they expecting me to say? This is way worse than the people who ask things like, does he speak much English? When he's lived in Canada longer than they've been alive. My ex is black and we have a child together. I can't think of any problems we encountered as a couple. But when my son was a baby, if I was alone with him in public, people would frequently ask me when I adopted him. Not the biggest deal in the world, but when they said it where he could hear it made him feel weird and I didn't like it. I am a white woman with Mexican husband. My father disowned me. Good riddance. Black husband. White wife. Deciding how to approach societal racial topics with our son when he gets older. Just to have someone say it, it really hasn't been an issue for us. 23 plus years of being together and it's never been an obstacle or an issue. Just hasn't factored into things. Not saying there aren't problems out there. There still are. But for us, we've gotten nothing but support and love from both sides of the family, friends, and anyone else we've dealt with. Just wanted to say that there's good stories out there too. White guy, Asian wife. Two kids have red and blonde hair. My wife is constantly offered babysitting jobs because people see her taking care of her own goddamn children. It's the people you grow up with who suddenly grow cold. You know, in any family there'll be people you get along with really well and others perhaps it's not so close, but you're all family. There's always the awful ones you tolerate. Their racist jokes and refusal to accept the 70s are over, but I don't mean those guys. Prepare to be frozen out by the sum of the ones you cherish most. The ones you like. The ones that are chill and you feel comfortable in each other's homes. You babysit their kids and share a glass of wine and a laugh at the weekend. The good ones. Those times when you used to laugh at your cousin's fake Jamaican accent together are gone. The idiot who grew up in Toronto is still doing the accent, but your friend and confidant is now on the other side of the room ignoring you. Suddenly you're not preferred babysitter. Invite to lunch dry up and what used to be big rambunctious dinners full of laughter end up being forced. Timid formalities. All because you dared to love somebody who they don't like the look of. And the fact we're not even married yet. It's going to get worse from here. White male here. Black woman. Colorism, from some black communities, is a real thing. And the way that this affects their perception of our relationship is nauseating. Though better than hostility. Your babies are gonna be so cute. Mixed babies are so cute. They're gonna have such nice hair. Maybe they'll have his light eyes. Yeah. This is bad enough when heard from black people. But just sound awful from anyone else. Please realize how ducked up this sounds. Even if it is your opinion. Though most people will admit that blue eyes on a brown skinned person are very striking. Does whiteness and less kinky hair make my babies cute? Babies are cute. My entirely black nieces are cute. My white nieces are cute. A lot of the Caribbean in particular has a fixation on lightness. Bleaching. Finding a white partner. Oh. But then maybe guys won't like white guys with their women. And the girls won't like white girls with their men. despite dating outside their race themselves, chasing the lighter skinned men women around like gold, etc. She has been congratulated on getting herself a white man. It's really ducked up. I always get told, well, he isn't one of those Mexicans, after they make an extremely racist remark before finding out that my fiancé is Mexican, and that his parents legally came here from Mexico. White guy married to my Mexican wife. They eat spaghetti for Thanksgiving. I'm married to a Turkish man. I am American. It is baffling to me the sheer number of times my husband has been gawked at and whispered about in public, like he's some sort of animal. He's a pretty good looking, normal guy, but happens to have Middle Eastern features. In today's society, with many Middle Easterners being vilified, I've had people ask me if he is Muslim and how I feel about that. He's not. And if he were, so, I've had people insinuate that everyone from his country is dangerous and, the saddest, I've had one person ask me if he was affiliated with any terrorist organizations. We get scolded by numerous people every time we decide to travel to Istanbul to see his family, which we try to do once a year. We are vigilant and don't travel mindlessly. We've had much practice. On a non-race specific note, the comments about the green card get old. No, we did not get married just so he could obtain a green card. No, we didn't meet online and get married without having met before. No, he didn't pay me to marry him for a green card. Surprise, we married each other because we love each other. A concept. I know. Judgment ostracizing are terrible things. 11/10. Do not recommend. I'm the Sri Lankan husband of a super pale white British wife. To be honest, in 2016, in the UK, nothing, other than elderly relatives thinking there's something exotic about me. There's absolutely nothing. I don't really even think of myself as anything other than a regular British man. In fact, when the police ask me to choose my ethnicity, I pick IC1 white male, despite being an olive mocha kinda color. Glad to say that society, in general, doesn't seem to even realize our relationship is interracial, the way it should be. Don't get me wrong, I'm sure there are folks out there, but luckily it's not something I've been exposed to since at least the early 90s. Iranian ex-mother-in-law was never happy that her only son married a red-haired Christian girl. Life is definitely more pleasant now, and I have had many interesting conversations with a lovely Christian Iranian man who comes to our church with his wonderful Hispanic Christian wife. I do not understand why people waste their lives and passions on such trivial differences when there are so many more important things that their time and resources could go towards. I'm white. She's black. Really? I can only remember one instance where there was an issue. We ran into a friend of my wife's one time, and the woman called her husband. They were both black. Over to meet me. He walks over. The friend starts saying, "This is so-and-so's husband." The guy looks at me with my hand out to shake his, and he just turns around and walks away. You could tell she was mortified and started apologizing profusely. I just shrugged. Actually, I just remembered one other time. When we were dating, the first time I took her to my favorite Sunday breakfast place, I realized how white it was. I thought this only happened in movies. But as soon as we walked in, everybody turned to look at us and all noise stopped. It was freaky. Nothing else happened, but those 2-3 seconds was enough. We never went back to that place again. I'm Chinese and my wife is Thai, so mainly we fight about the proper temperature of tea and the texture of rice. White male, engaged to a black female for 4 years before breaking up. Long story unrelated to our interracial status. I'm a Yankee from the West Coast and raised in the NE. She's purebred New Orleans. The cultural differences based on locale were what caused, not necessarily issues or incidents, but events. Nothing that generally caused a stink or resulted in more than a passing glance. If anything, the cultural dynamism just from our geographic backgrounds was more apparent than any racial issues, and usually all in good fun, except for restaurants in the South. It was always 50-50 on what kind of experience we'd get from the waitstaff because of race. I have a staunch northerner, don't look at anybody mentality. So if there were looks or sneers from other diners, I never noticed. They would always be pleasant and friendly to our faces, but half the time you could tell it was facetious condescending. and always directed at me, as in, "Really, dude, you picked a black chick? Traitor." On rare occasion our food would be tampered with. The worst time, we'd gone to a fancy steakhouse to celebrate. My steak was burnt, as in, solid char all around. She had a rusty wire coil, no idea where from, mixed into her salad. Suffice it to say, that meal was on the house in more ways than one. But, as they say up in Minnesota, could have been worse. Edit. Had a former close friend pull me aside not long after she and I got engaged, and ask me, "Dude, tell me you ain't effing this in?" I can't confirm, since I haven't spoken to him since. But I'm pretty certain one or both of his testicles doesn't work anymore. Cause I need them with the unholy force of 1,000 souls of the 54th Massachusetts wielding chainsaws etched with verses from the Emancipation Proclamation. That was the worst anybody ever said to me. Directly. Second edit for spelling and to extend my sincere gratitude for the gold. White man. Native American Hispanic wife. Both of us are Republicans. We went to a Lincoln Days fundraiser back in the summer to support our local Republican Party with a bunch of candidates for various state, Missouri, offices. We live in a very Caucasian county, so about 98% of the room, few hundred people, were white. After the event, a bunch of the candidates kept coming up to get photos with my wife. We know it was because they wanted pics of their candidate with one of the brown people in the room, of the 8 or 9 minorities in the room. Probably 6 were either candidates or their immediate families. We both got a huge chuckle out of it. She was actually adopted and raised by a white family, and if you just heard her talk, you would never know she is a minority. But, it was kind of funny to see these big time candidates. Candidates for MO governor, MO senator, and lots of statewide candidates, falling over themselves for the photo op to show how diverse they were. I'm Swedish-German. My wife is black. We always talked about how our kids would be black and look different than me, which I was fine with. But apparently, I'm so incredibly white that our 3 boys were born with light skin and brown hair. The middle kid even has blue eyes and blonde highlights. No matter. Pride in yourself and your race is still something we try to teach our kids. We read them Shades of Black, which teaches that black people come in every shade and with every feature. We thought we were laying a foundation for them to avoid the double discrimination that light-skinned black people face. Then, the other night during the presidential debate, my blonde-haired blue-eyed black son said, "I think Donald Trump might be one of those white people. So one of these days I'm going to have to teach my kid that he's surrounded by white people." Which I did not foresee.